Hey, Measuring Hero, Jay here. A few video blogs ago, we talked at a really high level with Mikhail about the medical industry. And then later we talked to Luis, and we actually measured an orthopedic knee. As we dive deeper into the subject of medical, a term or something always crops up, and that is Title 21. What is Title 21? What does it entail? And should we even be scared of it? So, Roger, thanks for coming. Appreciate it.
Thanks for having me, Jay.
Awesome. Okay, so usually when you don't have to go too deep into medical, someone always brings up FDA Title 21. What is it all about?
21 CFR Part 11, yes.
Exactly.
Is this what you're talking about?
Yeah.
Yeah, we hear this quite frequently, you're right, and more for some reason. Something is happening out there. And it's a regulation of the US Food and Drug Administration, and actually it asks for certain functionalities within the devices to make processes secure. And it's the aim, the idea behind this is actually traceability and data security at the end. In one sentence, what it's actually about. But if you want to know more, Jay, I can tell you the...
Let's dive in. What's the intent of... So it makes sense that the FDA said they set these regulations, but I mean, what does it actually entail? It can't just be one thing, right?
No, that's true. So basically, you can boil it down to, let's say, five main features.
Okay.
And if you want, we have this nice whiteboard.
Yeah.
I love to use it because it's all about software and digitalization. So first of all, the whole thing starts with user management. You need to have the system wants to know who is logging into the system. So the first functionality is user management. User management and all its functionalities like passwords, password security, changing of passwords after a certain time, automatic log off, white lists of certain passwords, blacklists of certain passwords, this type of things.
Okay, so user management.
User management and the capabilities of certain users to do some things. User management and user role management.
Understood.
That's one thing. And the second thing is actually for creating certain results, you want to use certain methods.
Okay.
We call it job templates.
Okay.
And this job template is actually the cookbook, right?
Okay.
Your results should be user independent and always the same. And the methods or the job templates, they need to be created in a certain way, and once they are done, you want to make sure that they are not modified anymore. So it's a kind of a release procedure of job templates or methods. So that's the second thing. It's like versioning and release of methods.
So you have to manage that.
Exactly.
Got it.
If two users use the same process, then you want to make sure that the results are the same.
Okay.
Things like that.
This
in combination
with
user management.
Yeah.
The third thing is audit trail. That's a very common term in this.
Yeah, I hear that all the time.
Audit trail. Audit trail.
So what does that mean?
Audit trail. Audit trail is actually a recorder sitting within the software and records every single step which is performed to create a result. So, and the audit trail asks for following terms like who, who, user management, who did what, when, and why. So this audit trail, this thing documents every single step for traceability reasons.
Got it. So we're understanding who did what, that they used the right version of it, and then all of the steps that were supposed to be accomplished were accomplished because you have a clear documentation of what what exactly was done to create that result.
Here we go. Okay. And at the end, once you have your result, mm-hmm. you want to make sure that the result is safe, that the result is unchanged and no one can manipulate it.
Okay.
Therefore, we come to the fourth step, which is electronic signature.
Okay.
So the electronic signature. But this is actually a key point. The user who performs that gives the electronic signature at the end. So this is all, this all comes together.
Just binds, it binds every, all of the processes to a certain.
Here we go. So they all play together.
Okay, okay.
And last but not least, there's another one called disaster recovery, right? Like disaster recovery. And this simply means if something breaks down, mm-hmm. your PC breaks down with what something happens, you want to make sure that you're back in production in your medical or whatever pharmaceutical production as fast as possible.
Right.
Therefore, backup strategies, backup and restore procedures are part of this.
So at its core building blocks, when someone says FDA compliance, they're really talking about these five things, right?
They might talk about more, but these are the main five high level features.
Sure. Sure.
As I said, in user management, there are detailed features, versioning, mm-hmm. obviously, as well. Audit trail is also, there's a lot of knowledge in behind it, but
sure.
these are...
The big blocks.
These are the big blocks.
Yeah, yeah.
We put this kind of functionality into the software on a very, very early stage, because you can imagine, Jay, audit trailing, recording every single step needs to be put in the very deep framework of a software. This is a lot...
It's not something that you can just... patch on top.
Exactly. It's not an add-on. Not at all.
It has to be baked into the...
Yeah, exactly. And therefore, I mean, we integrated that, I think, in the first or in the second release. And since then, all what we are doing within our software can be made GXP compliant. And this helps us a lot. I mean, whatever. Talking about medical application, talking about our brand new product like technical cleanliness, layer thickness, non-metallic inclusion. Every standard-based evaluation can be made GXP compliant by just adding this module. Done.
Okay. So my head's exploding. So you called this GXP. What does GXP stand for?
Well, that's a good question.
Yeah.
Right. GXP is like the G is for good, the X is a placeholder, and the P is for process. The name says it already, so it's about making processes good, right? It's about making processes more stable, more reliable, more secure,
and
more user independent,
this type of
thing. And so this is what... why we call it GXP.
Yeah, and then also, if I'm hearing you correctly, what I think we're doing is taking good processes that we had to do for the FDA, but why stop at FDA, right? We can, at medical, can we apply good practices to anything, automotive, you know, whatever, right? So taking what we've learned here and applying it, good practices are good practices, right?
I love that. I really love that question, because this is also what's in my mind since a long time. I mean, every production process, everywhere where you rely on reproducible results, mm-hmm. these features are super, super helpful, because this is what you want to achieve at the end, right?
So it sounds like what we have is a solution that will help us become, help a customer become Title 21 compliant. We call it GXP. I think we've spent a lot of time talking about it. Can we see it now?
Can see it. But I have to disappoint you a little bit, because you cannot see that much, because as I mentioned, it's so deeply in the genes. It's just a microscope and a piece of software. On some areas, you can see certain functionalities, like, of course, I can show you the audit trail and the user management, but since it's not an add-on, it's deeply involved in the software. It's just
part of the software.
It's just there, right.
Cool.
It's just there. But sure, if you want.
Let's see it, yeah.
Let's see it.
Alrighty.
So Jay, you wanted to see a job template. So I'm going to start one, which actually the first step is, the next is actually the live image where we acquire here we go, that was fast, that's the picture, everything, every detail in focus. We want to know the diameter of this half circle and some distances. Part of the job template does automatically put in the measurements. Need to adapt a little bit. Now, Jay, this is the, you remember, this is the in the audit trail of who did what, when, and why, because now I changed something and the system asks, why did you change this measurement? And I need to give a comment.
Okay, so you made a change and it's not necessarily a bad change, but just something that has to be documented.
Got it, exactly. For traceability reasons, the auditor wants to know why I changed that. It doesn't need to be something bad, just everything which is not documented doesn't exist. Mm-hmm. So the last step is a report. We put in the image. So this is the report. And at the very end, obviously, when all results are saved, mm-hmm. the system asks for an electronic signature.
So that's your there's your fourth block, if you will.
Here we go. This is actually, I did that. As the logged in user, give the signature for this mm-hmm. report. For electronic signatures, you need to give a commitment reason. So let's say released. It's all saved on a database. Done.
And that's it.
That's it.
All right, and for you out there, I hope you enjoy this too. Don't forget to stay safe and stay healthy, and see you next Thursday.